when you know how the wind blows, it's gonna be a cold time. When you know how the wind blows, strange things cross your mind. Many tales of woe that won't let go until the sun comes shining through. Nights are long when you are alone, and the days never end. When those clouds go away and the sun says, hey,
it's gonna be
your best.
He's gonna be here any second.
Don't worry, darling. He'll be here soon enough.
doesn't. I'll be right there.
Arby, darling.
Where is he?
At church.
Well, did he like them?
Hated them.
Arby, darling.
Helen.
Well, what do you think? You see, we decided to stay away from all the punk crap. We feel that women should look like women. Hourglass figures, plunging necklines, you know?
Yeah, yeah. Well, sounds good. Maybe we can talk about it. Some other time.
Was it something I said?
Not just me. It's all the girls. He has absolutely no right to be in there.
Why did you grab her ass?
Because it was there.
Did he hurt you?
Michael, now.
Terry.
Yeah.
She's 19 years old, for God's sake.
I know. Helen, look at these hands. Perfect control. Right? But... see what I mean?
Now, if you feel the need for the laying on of hands, I suggest you see a faith healer. Understood?
Yeah.
This is a sophisticated business.
Yes, it is, and I'll make it up to you, Helen. I swear.
You're lucky you take good pictures. Goodbye, Terry.
Helen?
Yes?
You're beautiful.
You seen this stuff?
Yeah.
What'd you think of it?
It's all right. Don't you ever stop working? It's Sunday.
Well, it's the only chance I get to look at other people's stuff. Things that we can share together, but making babies isn't one of them. You know, I don't feel like it somehow.
I knew it! What do you feel like?
I don't know. Not Crepe Susie and Chocolate Mouse.
But you are hungry.
Starving.
This can't be normal. You must still be growing. What do you want?
It's not so much what as where.
Oh, Angie, not again.
Well, why not?
What is this thing you have for this place?
How can I explain it? I pass the door, start to salivate.
Come on.
gas here. Like who?
Can I help you, ma'am?
Let me see. I'll have, do you have a menu?
We will have one all dark, fries, dinner roll, coleslaw, jalapeno, medium Coke. And then two pieces, one light, one dark, coleslaw, corn in the cob without butter, glass of milk.
Will that be all, ma'am? $6.58, please. $3.40, two back.
Thank you. You're very lovely.
Thanks.
So it's a professional opinion. I'm a photographer.
I knew it.
I'd really like to take your picture, especially if you moved your hair. I'm sorry.
What? Over there.
Especially if you put the barrette on the other side.
You're weird.
I know.
Who's he with? His kid sister?
I have an idea.
What?
But you know what it is.
Let's
see, you've got this really nice studio.
Let's go.
Wow. I like your place.
Yeah, well, it does the job.
You really are a fashion photographer.
Yeah. Did you doubt it?
You weren't lying.
No.
Well, that's unusual.
All right, if you didn't believe me, why did you come?
Well, if you wait around for a man you can believe, you do a lot of waiting around. You know? I wish I looked like that.
Oh, God, why? Why? You look fantastic. I can prove it. Let me prove it.
Sure.
Let me tell you something. See, all these things I do for my living. Not my art.
You're a real artist.
Yeah, I would have to say yes.
I know an artist.
Mm-hmm.
He paints the sides of vans. No girls, though, only sunsets. Beautiful sunsets.
My art is in the bedroom.
That figures.
I'd really like to show it to you.
You would, eh?
I only show it to cowgirls.
Wow. I like it. Jesus H. Christ.
Now, this is the essence of femininity. Of course, it's represented in a purely graphic way.
Well, I've never seen anything like it before. Ever.
It's an environment. I mean, you forget about women. You forget about breasts. Rhythmic. It's a purely rhythmic pattern. Ba-boom, 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 ba-boom.
Yeah. You should give it a name.
Oh, I have.
What?
I call it transcendent.
Should call it something funny.
I'll work on it.
Tell me something.
Yeah.
What are you going to do with it?
Oh. Add to it. Let it grow. It'll demand patience. With sacrifice.
You considering one of mine?
What's wrong with the other one? This is a rogue. Call me when you're ready. Or you'll be number 73. And 74. Oh, nothing, just shots of the campaign.
I was referring to the tit.
Oh. It's just a tit I met last night.
Don't they usually travel in pairs?
Yeah, they do, but you know me, I'm very attracted to loners.
May I have my photograph, please?
Yeah. They're great, aren't they? I really got it this time, Helen. I got her at the decisive moment, just as she was relinquishing respectability.
Looks to me as if she's in pain.
Yeah, that's true, too, but I got her in that obscure zone where pain and pleasure meet.
Okay. That's all a little too profound for me. All I want is your run-of-the-mill, everyday masterpiece. Please do them again for tomorrow.
Oh, now what are you going to do, brood?
Well, it's just that I can't seem to do anything to make you happy.
Oh, God, somebody please tell me why I keep him here.
Because I take good pictures. Remember? Helen, do you mind very much that I'm in love with you? I really want to know, Helen, how you manage it. I mean, how do you do it? Don't you want it sometimes? An otherwise attractive, sophisticated, intelligent look.
Tomorrow.
You're blushing.
Am I?
Yeah. Helen, will you go out with me sometime?
I don't date people from work.
Why not?
Personal rule.
So if I didn't work here, would you go out with me?
No.
Why not?
You're not my type.
Not only am I your type, I'm in love with you.
God, I'm not getting through to you. Watch my lips. I want the pictures tomorrow. Terry!
What is this? I've never tasted anything like this.
With a wife from the East, you get all the gastronomic gifts of the Orient.
Would you care something else?
Oh, God, no, I'm full.
Okay, R.B. What are we doing here?
Talking business.
I thought you hated our stuff.
I hate anything I can't sell. But you ladies could be hot. If you let me manage you.
If it means working in synthetics, we're out.
I see.
I love synthetics. Almost as well as the real thing.
Great. We won't have our names printed on it.
You know, I took care of Paul and Henri when they were nobodies. And now, they are selling like hotcakes. Tell them, boys.
Tell them.
You're asking me?
Please.
When I met this fucker here, I fell in love so bad, I didn't know what I was doing. He had this little shop. And he asked me to cut clothes. He So I cut. And I cut. And I cut. Till I was numb in the hands and blind in the eyes. Then R.B. came along. Now I don't cut anything at all. Just drive my car. Travel to the islands. I'm bored out of my mind. I love it.
So do I.
So, what do you say, Senoritas? Is making a little money against your religion?
Would our profits be proportionate with your whole outfit or just our line?
That is an interesting question, Angie.
It certainly is.
What's the answer?
Well, I'm certainly willing to talk about it. Oh, by the way, Mo, have you looked in on the baby lately?
Yes, 15 minutes ago. He's sleeping.
Oh. What about you, Helen? You haven't said a thing. What do you think? What's the deal?
Where's the bathroom? It's upstairs.
It certainly looks pretty hopeless.
Certainly does.
When you came out of the sea, you looked like a Botticelli.
I wish I could make you happy.
You do. Very.
Came out of the water.
Oh, they're pretty.
Found them on the beach.
Oh? Where?
Where I left my bathing suit.
Uh-huh. What's your name?
Pineapple.
Hello, Pineapple.
Hello. My mother, she doesn't like me catching clamsters.
Well, you better go to your mommy, little girl.
I don't want to go. I want to stay here.
Oh, well, that's all right.
She'll see us.
So what?
Pammy! Pammy!
She's over here!
Pammy, come here! What are you doing over there? How many times have I told you not to take your bathing suit off at the beach? What did you do with her suit?
I left it over there, Mommy.
Look, I told you not to talk to strangers. You're not to do that.
Did you ever want a baby?
Once. When I was six.
Then?
Had a great time in college. When I became a model, I was a star. Besides, there wasn't anyone around I wanted to have one with. And it was you.
Is how you make babies.
But you need a specialist to put that in there.
That's it. Go! Okay, stop. Stop. That's boring. Okay, just spin. Spin! Turn your back. I don't want to see your face. Now look at me suddenly. Turn your back and look at me suddenly. Now, whoa, those eyes. That's it. Give me neck. Angles, one angle. Form to the shoulders, please. I want to see the clothes, not you. That's it. That's it. Come on, come on, come on. More, more. That's it. That's it. That's it. That's it. Good. Great. Okay. Go down. Go down. Come on. Go down. Down, down, Susie. Down. Come on. That's it. That's it. Ooh, you're scaring me. Look at the light. Turn your head towards the light. That's it. Lower your head, lower your lid. Give me more. Come on, give me more! Okay, good.
Someday, sweetheart, and probably someday soon, I'm gonna find you in some filthy gutter, wasted, broken, abandoned by whatever horny pig you've thrown your life away on. You know what I'm gonna do then, Susie?
I know. You'll leave me there.
Oh, no. No, I'll take you away from all that, and I'll clean you up, and then I'll take you home and fuck your brains out.
You know what?
What?
I just need to let you do it. Do you realize my hand is in your shirt?
Is it? What's it doing in there?
Okay. It doesn't turn you on. Fine.
Susie. You're too late. I'm saving myself for Helen.
Are you serious? Oh, my God. Don't flatter yourself, Terry.
What is that supposed to mean?
Helen is not interested.
Oh, really? How do you know that?
You mean to say you really don't know?
What?
Terry, you're a photographer. You can't be entirely blind.
Would you please get to the point?
Give me a break. You ever see Helen out with a man?
Sure. I've seen Helen out with lots of men, Susie. RB, she's gone.
Picture come into focus yet?
You are not.
Right now?
Well, that's what the woman said.
She did.
Good sign, isn't it?
Do you think so?
I hope so.
Oh.
What's going on?
Nothing dangerous. Harry, do come in.
No, I've been working all weekend, but I got him. Those are pictures, Helen. I got him.
Are you ready?
Yes. Oh. Look, why don't you come back this afternoon and we'll talk about them.
Let's go. Well, hi, Terry.
Hi.
Goodbye, Terry.
Goodbye.
Hi, I'm Marge Hirshhorn. My friends all call me Hirsch.
How do you do? I'm Helen Hunter.
And Jill of some. Coffee?
No, thank you.
No, thank you.
We want to adopt a child.
I see. And you are women living alone?
How do you mean?
You know, women living alone.
We live together.
Well, of course. And why shouldn't you? And you want to have a baby. What could be more natural?
Then it's all right.
Of course it's all right.
Oh.
Even leaving the feminist perspective out of it, the facts are on our side. Speaking strictly scientifically, modern research has proven conclusively that proper parenting can be provided by two members of the same sex. That is to say that role models involved in fathering and mothering are virtually unconnected with biology.
Great.
Unfortunately, those scientific findings are fairly recent and have not yet been accepted by society at the legal level.
Is that to say that two women cannot adopt a baby together?
Unfortunately.
I knew it.
However, let's not be unnecessarily pessimistic. There are exceptional situations.
For instance?
For instance, a situation is exceptional if the adoptee presents an ethno-sociological differentiation.
Well, that's some kind of a disease.
A pigmentary variation, for example, would make the situation exceptional.
You mean a skin color other than white?
I see I can talk to you as sisters, woman to women. His name is Gabriel, a lovely child. Quiet as a mouse, hardly ever cries.
We'll take him.
Where somebody else gets him.
Well, there's no danger of that. Lots of people have seen him, but in the end, they all came to the same decision.
Which was?
They didn't want to disrupt his ethno-authenticity.
What the hell is...
They thought that he would be uncomfortable in a white middle-class home.
We're a white middle-class home.
Yes, I know, but let me go on. Since you girls really want Gabriel, maybe we could break the rules.
Let's wrap him up.
Well, I'll have to talk to the head of the department. It won't be easy. He's a man, you know. He thinks that behavior is biologically determined. Can you believe? One of the most insidious things we women have to face today is scientific chauvinism, don't you think?
Well, let's talk to him then.
Well, I'll handle it. I know how to get around him. I think I can get him to agree to let you have Gabriel. You just put yourself in my...
Excuse me, Hirsch.
Oh, Dave, we were just talking about you.
How flattering. Got a second?
Of course. Hirsch was just telling us about Gabriel.
I'm not sure I understand.
You see, we live together. And we came here to see if we could have a baby. And Ms. Hirshhorn is suggesting that if we take Gabriel, perhaps there's a way that you could arrange it.
Ms. Hirshhorn said that.
Well, Dave, think of it. We can kill two birds with one stone here. We can find a home for Gabe, and we can make it a test case at the same time. The women's groups will back us, the black groups will back us, the civil rights people, the media. We can put ourselves in the forefront of progressive agency practices. We can let them have their baby.
Ms. Hunter, isn't it? And Ms. Olufsen? I'm sure you appreciate that Ms. Hirshhorn is only trying to help you solve your problem, but she is sometimes a little more enthusiastic than circumstances warrant. There is an adoption law, you know. We have to abide by it.
In other words, there's no goddamn way.
I'll see you in my office.
Oh, it's not the end of the world. Other things we could try.
Such as?
Well, artificial insemination. Check it out.
You want to get laid by Darth Vader? You see, at this point in time, I'm not all that interested in marriage. But I am very attracted to maternity. You see, I feel that one of the things of my basic existence is...
Thank you. $20.
Never mind.
I can come. I'm free on Saturday.
Doesn't leave many options, does it?
One, to be precise.
A man, to be precise. Same old dead end.
Mm-hmm.
What is it we have against men, anyway?
They always want so much.
What do you think he should look like?
Who?
Him. He should be young, presentable.
I don't think the physical is all that important.
Sperm would be healthier.
Angie, you're trying to manufacture the perfect baby.
Of course.
That's immoral.
It is?
Absolutely. Careful.
Well, we have to find someone.
That's for sure.
You have to be intelligent.
Sensitive.
And gentle.
And aggressive, self-confident, dominating. Yet he should be undemanding and submissive.
Good luck. Hi, dear.
Hi.
Thank you.
Well, maybe we should hit the discos.
Is that what you consider my taste in men?
I didn't know you had a taste in men.
I feel as if I'm in the bowels of a machine.
Well, if you don't like it, we can go somewhere else.
Oh, we're here now.
Angie? Hi, where have you been? It's me, Carl, don't you remember?
Carl, hi!
It's been a long time.
Yes, a long time, my friend Helen.
Hey, Helen, how you doing? Listen, a friend of mine are out here. We're going to dance as long as we can. Come on and join us.
I'm here.
I'm glad you didn't leave.
I'm sorry, I just had to get out of there. Still feel like dancing?
Yes. With you. I love you.
I love you too. Oh, the big sewing machine broke down last week.
Oh, yeah, that's what I remember that. Ah, for your information. Oh, there it is. Look at the interest we're paying on that last loan we took out. You want something?
No. You called me.
Oh! Right. Helen wants to talk to you.
I do? The layout you did on Susie? Excellent.
It is?
Oh, yes. Sit down.
Yeah.
I've been thinking. And, I have decided that I have not been paying nearly as much attention to you lately as I should. And, well, in order to make the... Oh, God damn it! Why don't you just come to the beach house this weekend for dinner? Alone? That is, unless you're otherwise engaged.
No, I'm that wise engaged.
Well, good. Then we'll see you.
And so that... Is that all?
That's all.
That's all. But then I'll... Susie. You're full of shit.
Helen, wake up. What time is it? He's here.
Yeah?
He's here.
Who's here?
Terry.
What's he doing here?
We invited him.
He didn't have to come.
Not.
It was embarrassing.
You knew completely about it. There was no reason to be embarrassed.
It has nothing to do with my knowing about it.
Well, the least you could have done would have made some kind of effort.
The least I could have done. Why don't we just forget about it?
Excuse me.
You have a question?
Yeah, I do. What the hell's going on?
Nothing.
Oh, I know that much.
Terry, there is something about Angie and me that you don't understand.
No, I do. I wasn't sure about it before, but I think I do now.
Well, it's a little more complicated than that.
I don't think that's possible.
Look, the truth is...
It was all a horrible mistake.
Oh, like hell! Truth is, Helen wanted to use you for a stud.
Stud?
You know, the inconvenient prerequisite for getting pregnant.
I'm sorry, Terry.
Well, I'm flattered.
Well, I couldn't have gone through with it anyway.
Oh. You had me fooled into thinking you cared about me.
I do care about you. That's where it all went wrong.
You want to have a baby? All you had to do was ask. Please, we would really like to have another bottle of this stuff. This stuff is
yes, sir.
Bordeaux. Okay?
I know, sir.
Yeah, it's red.
It's really nice.
Yeah, it is. Oh, and don't forget, 1970.
Of course.
All right. He hates me.
Why so old?
The waiter?
No, actually, no, it is. 1970 is an incredibly good year for Bordeaux.
Mm-hmm.
No, it is. It's very good.
Learning something new every day.
You do indeed. Here's to learning something new every day. which is great, right? Yeah. you know. I've never slept three in a bed before.
Oh. That makes three of us.
This is where I live.
Great layout.
Wait till you see the bedroom. This way, follow me, please. Helen? Helen? Feel free to join us anytime. Come along.
Don't forget where you parked the car.
You weren't listening to me. I live here.
Oh, that's clear, the authority.
God. Okay.
Stairway to heaven. Helen.
Look, couldn't we do this another night?
What do you mean, another night, Helen?
I'm not in the mood.
Yes, of course you are. You are in the mood.
No, I'm really not in the mood. I'm going to be sick.
No, you're not. No, you're not.
Yeah, I promise. No. I'm going to throw up.
You are not going to throw up. Not until the second month.
Wait a minute.
It's
all right, we will all stay close to each other.
Oh, shit, my purse.
Your purse? Even your purse? I'm about to be raped by a sex maniac in an elevator, and you're worried about your purse?
You ask for it. You go and do it.
No.
Yes.
Oh, thank
you. No, go. Andy, go. Andy, go. Andy, go. Fuck the guy. Why didn't he get some of the baby? Leave me alone. Andy. Helen.
You okay, lady?
You almost killed me, stupid. What the hell do you think you're doing?
I'm sorry, I didn't see you. I didn't hit you, did I?
I'm looking for a car.
What kind?
Ordinary.
What color?
Gray.
Would you like to drive around and look for it?
Could we?
I bet.
Helen, she's probably home by now.
Let's go downstairs and see.
All right, then.
What's your name?
Sven McCulloch.
Are you Swedish?
Yeah. No one ever asked me that before. Well, my mother is. I'm half a Swede.
Me too. Angie Olofsson.
How about that? Shouldn't you be looking for the car?
Drive.
Sure.
Yeah?
Angie, where are you? Where is she?
Well, she's probably upstairs by now.
Well, that's ridiculous. She doesn't even know what floor you live on.
Well, why don't we go see?
Would you like a drink?
Come out of there, please. Helen. I'm the last person in the world to be scared of.
Helen, please.
So, what's a nice Swedish boy like you doing lurking about in the garage?
Wouldn't want to hear about that.
Dying.
I was gonna meet this girl I know. She lives in the building. Her parents are in Florida. It was supposed to be our big night. You know what I mean?
I'm sorry.
I got to the door. And you know who answered? Bill Murphy. You know who Bill Murphy is?
No.
I'd say that's pretty fickle of her, wouldn't you?
Yes. Pretty fickle. Ah! Sven, I think we ought to get out of the car.
There.
there.
Don't worry about it.
Interesting.
Want to know what I call it?
Titillation.
Hello. Could we have a room for two? Mr. and Mrs. What did you say your name was?
Me?
Miss. Thank you.
Now what'll we do? Wrong question.
Wait a second.
Yes, I know. Stop. Rush.
Oh, my God. Rule number two. Forget all about that, okay?
Would you like some conversation first?
Not necessarily.
What then? Are you ready for foreplay?
Why don't you just relax?
I'll show you a good time.
Okay.
Close your eyes. One, two, three, go.
The window.
Ellen.
Close the drapes.
We're on the 34th floor.
Close the drapes.
Okay. One, two, three, go.
I know that what we are about to do is a perfectly reasonable thing to do. I know that there's no reason whatsoever that I should feel any guilt.
Not the girl was just supposed to lie there.
Not the girl.
Thank you.
Clearly, we're both responsible adults. But all the same, I really feel...
Helen.
Yes?
Shut up.
I guess so.
Do you like it?
It's not bad. Don't do that.
Operator. Operator.
Hello?
Helen.
Yes, my love. Do you love me?
I love you. I love you. You know I love you.
Oh. 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 Oh.
Helen. Thank you. Finn, sorry.
Don't mind me.
Was it all right?
100%.
Oh.
And you?
It was lovely.
Aren't we gonna have a post-coil cigarette?
Some other time. I've gotta go. I'm sorry. Sorry. Bye.
Bye. I gave it my best shot.
Thank you.
But you didn't exactly do it alone. I mean, I think I deserve a little attention. It is weird, isn't it?
It sure is.
Yeah, I mean, Susie, what the hell am I supposed to be? Am I supposed to be a lover? A partner? Father.
She's your boss. Remember that.
Yes.
Good.
Well, then what am I? Hired gun?
Come on, let's go.
I don't really feel like seeing a movie today. Let's just stay home.
Oh, come on. I want to get out of here.
I know what's on your mind.
Helen, would you please lay off with that? He was just a kid. I saw him for one night. I would have completely forgotten about it if you didn't mention it all the time.
What are you so crabby about?
I'm not crabby.
Having your period?
No.
What's happened to you girls?
Nothing. Must have been something we had for lunch.
Well, congratulations. Who are the happy fathers?
What about the deal, RB?
Oh, yeah, that's right. Now, remember, I came to you first.
Yes, with a lousy offer.
That was 6 months ago. But we can work things out.
How do you mean?
I'm the only person who can sell that stuff you guys whip up. And I can use all of it.
Good.
But there's a catch. We put everything under Paul and Henri's label.
Prick.
Maybe. But that's the way it's going to be.
Look. We sell style. We don't sell rags.
Now, if I let you girls have your own label, that would just be like cutting my own throat, right?
Look, RB, we came here to talk about a deal.
What is going on in here?
You want to listen or not?
You know, before me, Paul and Henri didn't even exist. I invented them. I made their names famous. And you dare to come to my office to make me an offer?
Why don't you just shut up and listen for a minute?
Listen to what, madam? Everything has been said.
I suppose it has.
So much for our fabulous idea.
Doesn't know what is missing.
Why, Los Angeles? I guess you'll have to get along without us.
I'm not going to let that happen. Who says we need RB to sell our stuff in L.A.?
We need someone who understands the business. Someone who can sell. And someone who isn't pregnant.
Know anyone?
What's wrong? Dizzy.
Sure. Think they like each other?
They better. Little bastards.
No, don't. Really, don't worry. The doctor said she's okay, Terry. She's recovering and she'll be okay. He's taking her off the drugs today and he said that she'd be up in a week or two.
I beg your pardon.
Well, I'm your girl from Los Angeles.
I don't fool around the way I used to.
Oh, that doesn't sound like you. What's going on?
Nothing is going on. I'm fine.
I don't believe you.
Must be something wrong with you.
I'm not going to talk about it.
Oh, hiding something from me.
I'm not saying a word. It's just a little project that I'm working on.
Aha, a little project, eh? Come on, you've got to tell me.
Well,
come on.
Okay, I'll tell you about it as soon as we make up our mind. As soon as I make up my mind.
All right, you better, though. Otherwise, you'll have a breach of contract.
Angie, enough. Goodbye. Take care of yourself. Good night. Oh, listen. Tell Helen I want her to get better. And tell her I love her.
I called the doctor.
You did?
He wants me to go to the hospital.
What for?
Just a checkup, nothing serious.
Hmm.
What's eclampsia?
Don't tell me. Name of a Polish girl. No? A tropical insect. Gourmet dish.
He said...
What? He said what?
I said, if I was a few years younger, that it might... are greater now.
Helen, is this serious?
What do you like?
Again. Why is it always you that thinks about him?
Tell me more. It was a blurred image to begin with, and I forget it more every day. I wish we had a picture of him. He was blonde?
Yeah.
You're going to have a blonde baby.
I'm going to have a Swedish baby.
You heard from Terry?
Oh, yeah. He rang up. He's fine. He said that interest in our designs is picking up. Business is going well.
You see, who needs RB?
Absolutely.
Angie, what's the matter? It's all right. What's the matter?
Baby. Is it a girl? Where's my baby?
Helen, the baby was stillborn. It was a boy.
Won't be long. You're doing just fine.
Oh, I'm starting again.
Yeah.
I call it? The miracle of life. Having a baby is the miracle of life. Quattro. Four. Four fucking miracles. How's your wife?
She's not my wife.
Well, hope the kid's all right.
I'm not the father.
This is the father.
It's a girl!
What? You can't do that, Terry. Things are going too well. Look, you cannot leave the job now, not even for 1 week. All right. Please, don't do anything foolish, okay? First chance you get him, RB, I'll cut your balls off. You know that.
Will you stop worrying so much about RB?
And just keep in touch. Oh.
Will you stop getting so excited?
You're right. Drives me out. You want to take her?